Now, so the topic for the day, right, is it possible to generate explosive return, right, from ETFs? So I'm going to talk about this ETF, which is quite something hot, a hot topic, right? And it's called ARK ETF, the Raiders of the Lost ARK. Huh? Now, ARK ETF. Huh? So I'm going to talk about the ARK ETF, but the ARK ETF, you know, I cannot talk about ARK ETF without talking about who is the creator and founder of this ARK ETF. Now, this lady that created this ARK fund management, right? You can see this on the ARK investment fund, right? And her name is called Cathie Wood, or sometimes it's called Cathie Wood. Cathie Wood. Now, if you want, can you please go to our YouTube channel, Value Investing Academy? You know, I painstakingly shoot this video. They are poor thing. You know, there are only 296 views. Quite pathetic, right? So I beg people to like, you see? Beg people to like, you see, got 22 likes. what to do? It's like the John Woo or Wang Jiawei, right? Go and shoot a movie. Leh. After shoot a movie, in the cinema, kosong, empty. So it's the same thing. Lor. You know, I do all this. Make sure that I comb my hair properly, wear contact lens. So 22, like, reality. Reality, right? Reality, huh? Okay, good. Go and watch, huh? Now, just go there and like. Just tap. Okay, good. So let's get back to this explosive return. Now, so what I did was I went to the website. It's called ARK Invest, right? It's quite transparent. You go to the website, they'll list out. In total, they have 7 ETF. You can see here, right? ETF. But the one that people talks about are these 5. So I'm going to ignore this 2. I'm just going to talk about this 5. 5, right? So it's quite transparent. You go and click. They'll talk about what are the funds. You know, like all website, you know, they show the details. But let me share with you the purpose of how Cathie Wood thinks. You see, Cathie Wood is not Buffett. It's not Buffett. Their style are different. Now, when I say the style are different, there is no right or wrong. And when you prefer whatever style, right, it doesn't really matter. For example, last time when I played table tennis, when you play table tennis, some people are very defensive. Defensive as in they don't smack people, you know, in terms of the table tennis. They are very defensive. They play a defensive game. So they can win by being defensive. But there are some people who win, you know, smack, serve certain ball, spinning ball. So they win by offensive. So ultimately, there are many investors. Yeah, just like there are many different kinds of fruits. When a person like to eat Mao San Wang durian and let's say someone like to eat durian, I like to eat mango. I cannot say you eat durian is wrong, man. And the person also cannot say I eat mango is wrong, right? Each of us, we have our own passion. We have a different belief system. So we want to find someone who is our role model and we share the common belief. Okay. Now, during the class, I already shared what is a Warren Buffett belief. And because he's quite old school, there are only 2 types of company that he look at. He only want to buy a company that is good. That means with proven track record. Anything that's not proven, unlikely he's going to buy that grows. And of course, that's cheap. And because of this, he want to have evidence rather than believe that it's really good and grow based on numbers and it's really cheap. Then, of course, remember, if the first one, if you cannot find the first type of company, he'll go for those that is good and cheap. So that is his philosophy. So that philosophy worked for Buffett. Yeah. So ultimately, as we grow as an investor, right, initially, you may like Buffett. You may like durian. After that, as you grow older, your taste may change, which is fine. And then some people, maybe I want to be like half Cathie Wood, half Buffett. Or I don't like Buffett anymore. You mean Buffett is the best, man? Now, can he outperform 400%? He cannot. What? So I'm going to shift to Cathie Wood. So it's fine, you know, because ultimately, it's the investor's money. So what is Cathie Wood's beliefs? What is her intention? So you choose the school that you felt that's most aligned with your values. So in her website, right, she shared a curve, right? How early adopters look like the curve, their journey. And remember, these early adopters, are like the fast growth stock in our class. So remember, there's a fast, medium, slow. And remember, during a fast growth, right, I shared that usually in the early years, they lose money or they make little money. And then they reach one point and suddenly the sales are explosive. So Cathie Wood is looking for this type. But Buffett is not looking for this type. Buffett is looking for, you know, good track record. So remember, 2 school of thought, right? Yeah, so all roads lead to Rome. So when I go to a website, let me do some simple innovation. There's some description. But anyway, what she's trying to say is that this entire graph has different phases and it grows through different journey. And the journey of fast growth stock and early adopters are very different from the Buffett. Okay, yeah. So her fund is to focus on these early adopters, fast growth. So in us, we want to catch them before people discard it, before they make money, or we want to catch them where they make a bit of money. But Buffett is, you want to catch them where we already have a track record. Yeah. So remember a different school, right? Yeah. So they go through these four different phases. Huh? Hey, by the way, just in case halfway through, if my connection went off, you just pardon me, right? Because since yesterday night, I don't know why, I think my house got this short circuit. So sometimes it may go off. It may go off, then my Wi-Fi may go off. Huh? So I'll just finish as much as I can, right? Yeah. Yeah. So I'm going to go through the five funds very quickly, not line for line, very quickly, right? So the first fund is called ARK Innovation ETF, ARK and then K. Okay, I flash up very quickly, right? Now, the expense ratio is not the VOO. Remember, VOO is 0.03. So this is 0.75. Okay, huh? So their history is not like 64 years. It's 2014, Cathie Wood, and so on. So I think the easiest way, right, is to show you the company. So remember, it started off in 2014. So it's about 5 years. 5 years, right? So it's a 5 years. Yeah. So since inception, the ROI is 36%. Yeah. So remember, 36%, of course, is higher than the this annualized return. This is not the 5 years return. 5 years return, of course, will be more. You can take 36 times 5, 100 something, right? Okay. So the annualized return is 36. So these are the companies that you can see. Of course, Tesla, you know, most of people who have heard before, but some of it, some companies I never heard before. This zero, you know, never heard before. Don't worry, later I'm going to give you a summary so you don't have to take photo, right? So this is fund number one, ARK Innovation ETF. Yeah. Then the next one is called ARK Autonomous and Robotics ETF. Usually the name is quite sexy, right? You can read about it. If photo, 3D printing, space exploration, you know, something like that. And that talks about, again, the inception date is 2014. Expense ratio is about 0 point something. The same fund manager is Cathie Wood. So let's look at ROI. ROI is lesser than the previous one. It's about 25%. And these are the top 10 companies. The number of companies, I think, is about 20 or 30. But these are top 10. Top 10, right? So these are autonomous and robotics ETF. Don't worry, I'll go through this quickly. Later, I put a summary, right? Then another one is next generation internet ETF. So the name is very futuristic. You know, cloud computing, all this, very sexy. About 5 years. Expense ratio is also about 0.7 something. And these are the company. This one, can you see? Oh, 41. So far, it's the highest. You know, a Tesla. You see, there's a Bitcoin trust. Okay, second largest, right? Now, the third one, the fourth one is Genomic Revolution ETF. Of course, with the pandemic, they focus on all this, bioinformatics and so on. So on the left, same thing, inception, about 5 years, Cathie Wood. A ROI is about 29%, smaller than just now the internet ETF, right? So these are the company. So right now you see Tesla is missing because this is more on like life science, right? Yeah, biotech, Teladoc, health, and then so on. Yeah, recently I discovered this. This is quite interesting. Vertex, right? Yeah, this is quite interesting. Yeah. Okay, so last one. Last one is the most sexy one, right? Is this ARK FinTech. This is the fifth one. FinTech Innovation ETF, right? Yeah. So in the blockchain, you know, all that. So this is very new. Just take note, right? It's 2019, huh? I think it's about a year plus. Okay, yeah. Same thing. Expense ratio tend to be on the high side, right? And it's still Cathie Wood, okay? So you look at the ROI, it's the highest. Highest, but of course, it's not really Apple because it's still quite new, right? Yeah. You know, PayPal and so on. Okay. So so many. I'm just going to put it side by side. Yeah. So I spent a lot of time trying to cut and paste. So just appreciate the effort. So ladies and gentlemen, can you just do a screenshot of this? Yeah, so that you don't have to go to the website. Okay, good. So what I did was I intentionally aligned the highest return, which is on the left. So that's easy. And the lowest one on the right. Now, bearing in mind that this is this. Yeah, you know, sometimes luck will play a part. Luck will play a part. Yeah, okay. So again, highest return, all the returns are here. This is provided by, you can always go to the website. And of course, this is the company. So what I'm going to do is, what happened was this afternoon, right? I wanted to see out of this five funds, right? Are there some companies where Cathie Wood really likes. Yeah, or maybe her team really like. Yeah. So I noticed there's some overlap. So what she did was, it appears that she's recycling the company. Right? She take this company, put here, and take the company, put there, and then start a fund. Then after that, she take this company, put here, add some new, and then start another fund. Okay, huh? So I'm going to highlight some, right? Remember, this is not my belief, but this is facts, huh? Okay, so I'm going to just put out, right? Okay, so the top 10, I happen to see Tesla in these three funds. After this, you can also take a photo, right, huh? Square. Yeah, Square. Teladoc. Zillow. I have no idea what they are. Shopify. Okay. Now, if you want, you can also take a photo of these and then you can erase the previous one. So you realize that the one, right, the first three funds have a few overlap. One, two, and three. I'm not very sure. Is there a coincidence or they really like all this company? So I better duplicate it. Or they want to do like some form of cross-selling. I think some companies, I better produce a lot of products so that when people buy, invest, I can collect management fee. I do not know. Lah. So yeah. So, but let me leave facts as such. Huh? Now, so now the next question is, maybe there's an error. Lah. There's an error. You all go and correct for me. Okay. Huh? Now, so the key thing is now what? We are at this point and we have this ARK ETF as a glance. So what does it mean? Now, ultimately, what I can do is I can share with you the performance. And then later, I'll make a comparison. Then you all see what makes sense to you. What makes sense to you, right? So, okay. So the next part I want to talk about, which is maybe about just give me 10 and 15 minutes. I'm just going to talk about the fundamentals of the ARK FinTech Innovation Fund. And this is just like a snapshot. Right? It doesn't represent all ETF. And the reason why I use this is because this one got the highest return. Ma. Yeah. So if I want to learn from her, right, it's like I want to understand what's her thinking. Okay. Because I'm not so good with the fast growth stock. So I wanted to learn from her how she can pick stocks, just like how I learned from Buffett. So we keep our mind open, right? So what I did was I want to understand the fundamentals of the company, just a snapshot and see whether does it make sense. So remember, right, this ARK, right, with the highest return, right? These are the top 10. So what I did was I used the tools that all of you have access, right? And I look at the fundamentals. Now, I cannot go through all because it's just too much work. So I'm just going to look at one criteria, right, which is called profitability. Yeah, by using the EPS. EPS, right? So I just use EPS and look at the share price. Now, so if you look at this company, remember top 10 holding. First one is Square Inc, right? Square Inc. 2 years making money, one, two, but the share price shoot up. Yeah. So in other words, what does this mean, right? It simply means that this company has not really proven itself yet, but the market feel good about it. They feel good. Yeah. So this feel good is not a belief, but it's reflected by the share price because the PE is 508. So in other words, they make $1 of EPS per year. People are okay to pay 508. So in other words, they do not mind overpaying. So in other words, they already pay into the they already buy into the company's future, assuming that, you know, they are okay. They are fine. They are fine, right? So this is their belief, which is reflected in this stock price quantitatively. So there's PE, right? Then, of course, PayPal. Now, if I look at this, it really looks like a Buffett stock. Buffett stock, right? So I think it's fair. You know, EPS go up. And because the EPS go up appears to be like curve compounding, can you see the share price also go up? But the PE, of course, PayPal, you know, this kind of tech stock tend to be on the high side. And then 68.16, still on the high side. But this is not a good measure of fast growth stock. Yeah. But a fast growth stock is better gauged by this ratio called PEG ratio. And this PEG ratio is popularized by Peter Lynch. So he said that a fast growth stock, PEG ratio can only be used for fast growth stock. So in other words, a fast growth stock is considered cheap, right? If the PEG ratio, right, is less than one. Yeah, so in this case, factually, right, it's not, you see, it's not. But of course, if you do not mind, you know, it's your own decision. So this PayPal, right? So remember, PEG is just an indicator. Cheap is less than one. If it's more than one, based on value investing framework, it's not cheap. Okay, then there's another company called Silvergate. PE is 114. It's really fast growth. PEG is 3.14. Okay, then the next one, I show you the graph. So not all companies are bad. It's a mixture, right? So there is this zero, the EPS, unfortunately, is going down, but the share price is going up over here. So you see how the market feels. You lose money, huh? You every single year lose more and more, huh? It's okay. I'm willing to pay at a high price with the belief that you will get better. Remember, right? Like the author's belief. Yeah, get better, right? But there is no numbers to justify the belief yet. Maybe there's something qualitative that we do not see. Yeah. So Intercontinental appears to be like Buffett, you know, uptrend, consistent. But the curve doesn't seem to be quite curved, huh? PE is low as compared to the rest. PEG is still more than one. And then Tencent holding, everybody know, all the Hong Kong students will know, you know, PE 42, PEG is 1.35, very close to one. Share price go up. Yeah. So remember, the fastest growth stock are all these stocks, right? Pinterest, I have a Pinterest account. It's still losing money, but the share price go up. And because it's losing money, right? That's why there's no PE, there's no PEG. Okay. Shopify, PE is 433. So it has only made 1 year of money. Yeah, but for every dollar, people are okay. The stock market is okay to pay $433. Okay, so that is a perception, which is fine, right? Now, C Limited is losing more and more money, but the share price go up and up. That means despite the fact they lose more money is okay. You can keep on losing money, but you have great potential. I'm going to pay you more and more. So this is the stock market's perception. Huh? And last one, right, is this, this is an interesting name. This is a Hong Kong company, Year Car Limited. Yeah, 1 year make money. That's why there's a... PE is 258. And because there's 1 year, there is no growth rate, right? So there is no PEG ratio. So share price is on the upside. So if you look at all the companies, whether they make money, don't make money, right? The share price seems to defy gravity and then it goes up. So let's do a summary. After that, let me flash this out, then take a photo, okay? Now, so in total, I share with you the top 10, not all, top 10 companies. 8 are listed in US, 2 in Hong Kong. Out of the 10, right? 4 looks like Buffett stock, which is quite nice, right? They have 4 consistent EPS upward trend. 3 are losing money. 3 just, you know, like 1-2 years make money. Okay. So you can see, right? 4-3-3, right? Yep. Assuming all are fast grower, assuming they are all making money, the PEG, right, are not cheap. They are because they are more than one and range from 1.35 to 3.14. Yeah. And the reason why I need to provide facts are so that... You can make better judgment. And last one, right? The PE ratio, right? Range from 29 to 508. For those with at least 1 year of profit. Of course, if there is no profit, right? Then there is no PE ratio. Okay. So, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to leave this thing here for just a few seconds, right? If you want, you can take a photo of this. So that in case people talk about, remember, this is only the last ARK ETF, which is only in 2019, which is the highest ETF. Because when people have a conversation, they don't talk about the low one. They always talk about the few hundred percent. So at least when people talk about this, you know, oh, okay, is this an ARK FinTech Innovative ETF? So I'm aware of the top 10 about one-third make money, one-third don't make money, one-third just make money, you know, that kind of thing. Okay, Now, so let's move on, right? So let's, it's not the apple to apple comparison, but I'm going to put side by side so that you're at a crossroad that you can know what to do. Because the common question is, hey, can buy or not? You know, this type of question. Yeah, like if I say cannot, also like die. If I say yes, also wrong because I'm not licensed. So I'm going to just present the facts, right? Yeah. So here, remember S&P 500, like I say, it's not an apple-to-apple comparison, but you know, I just put it side by side and see is there some conclusion we can draw. So remember the history is 64 years since the beginning of time. ARK is quite new. And remember when ARK started, it was a bull run. So now they are, how should I say, they are riding on the trend. Okay, this S&P 500 has been through ups and downs. It's like a veteran in war, right? It's been through lots of things. 31 bear market, and 31 are actually counted. From the day S&P 500, I'm going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the ARK has been through one. The one is the most recent one, which is a V-shaped recovery, right? Yeah. So diversified is 500. They are very concentrated. All the companies, I would suppose I make assumption that more than 90% of the companies should be profitable. This one is mostly not or just started. Mostly not is a 1/3, right? And then just started is 1/3. Okay. Expense ratio is 0.03. Of course, if you use VOO or IVV, the expense ratio is higher. So like I say, you must compare side by side. So it's about 2.5 times. Annualized return, of course, this is far more superior. Yeah, because they ride on the bull run. This is 9 to 70%. Yeah, let me just show the next one. You can take a photo, okay? Now, So this is the funds, and these are seven. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the newest one, right, is two more, right? So AUM stands for assets under management. So if you look at the term, right, assets under management, that means they're managing some assets. So it simply means that, for example, right, for this ARK Innovation ETF, right, investors, they have collected this $24.37 billion from investors. Yeah. Of course, you want me to manage for you, you must pay me, right? Then the expense ratio, remember, the management fee is a subset of this expense ratio, is 0.75. It looks like it's quite standard. If based on the VOO, it's definitely not a low cost, but of course, the ROI is so high, right? So, I mean, you want high return, you pay me more. No? Okay, yeah. So if I take this, right, and I put in like 0.75% expense ratio, right? So I think for every year, right, the funds will make about 380 million. Yeah, or rather, maybe I shouldn't say make, or rather their expense, including the management fee, right, is 380 million. Yeah, so of course, some of these 380 million will go into the pocket of Cathie Wood, because she's the CEO, right, and she's the key fund manager. Yeah, so now she makes money out of this fee. Yeah. Yeah, makes money out of this fee, which is fair, right? Yeah, because she managed, man. Okay, yeah. So now is the crossroad. So what do you mean by crossroad, right? If I go back to here, so what are the things you can do? What are the things you can do? Now, I can only share some of my thoughts. Number one, S&P 500, I don't think it's a bad guy. Yeah. He has a long history. He has been through hell. Most of the companies are profitable. The expense ratio is low. Annualized return is, you see, this guy is not a bad guy because he didn't lose money. Yeah. Okay. So now you have a good guy, or rather you have a girl, right? And then you saw this guy, he may not be too handsome, but this guy's a decent guy, down to earth or whatever. Then suddenly another handsome guy, right? Like BTS or whatever, suddenly appeared. Oh, okay. Very short history. Been through a bear market, you know, and all this, right? So right now you're at a crossroad. So what do you want to do? I'm just throwing out. Number one, it can be a two-timer. Okay, number one, maybe my 20% put S&P 500, but let me just try it out. Maybe I just like a lottery ticket, I buy 1% of this up. Yeah, so ultimately it's you. You must find a licensed advisor to do this. So that's one possibility. Or you're old school, you're very faithful to S&P 500, just stick to this guy and then, okay, I know there's this and stop. So there are two things. One is a S&P 500. One is a S&P 500 plus a small or big slice of this ARK ETF. Okay, so it's a scenario one, scenario two. Another scenario that we could think out of the box is if Cathie Wood, because Cathie Wood presents the companies of the ETF, right, regularly on her website. So in other words, you can actually check the list. So in other words, if you are like Buffett, yet you want to be like a portion of Cathie Wood, like a hybrid. So what can you do? Remember, right, every ARK ETF, it shows the breakdown. It shows the breakdown. Like for example here, right, this supersonic, this ARK FinTech ETF, right? Wow, you know, some lose money and so on. But of course, you can always use her the components of her ETF as a reference. Remember SEGA? Yeah, as a search. For example, okay, this square, I look at this one, I'm a half buffer, I'm not so comfortable. You give you a miss, which is fine, right? Then you look at this PayPal. Hey, this PayPal looks okay. I'm going to look. I'm not going to buy ARK ETF, this ARK F ETF, but I'm going to buy the constituent or the components. Or you want to use it as an idea. See whether calculate intrinsic value, that's fine. So you can like take a look at PayPal, take a look at this Silvergate. Now, this Silvergate sounds interesting. Yeah, because I've never seen this before. So you see right now, right, if I keep open mind, I read for A, what is this Silvergate? So I got one idea. Okay. Now, then, of course, in intercontinental exchange, never heard before, looks like a Buffett stock. I may put this in my shopping list to do more homework. Tencent holding, same thing, right? So you can ignore all the so-called bad ones and you can keep all the good ones. Yeah. So this is a scenario number three. That means instead of buying the ETF, right, in which you feel uncomfortable, right, you can find those that are okay, that meets your Buffett style, right, in the ARK ETF, which can be any of the ARK ETF, Tesla or whatever. Okay, yeah. So in other words, let me just do a summary. Crossroad over here, right? So number one is you can just do S&P 500 or whatever lah. Okay. Second thing is you can do S&P 500 plus up the percentage, you know, you decide. Okay. The third one, right, is you can look at the components. Yeah, of the ARK ETF, PayPal, you know, and so on. And then see whether can you apply the Buffett style, right, onto a Cathie Wood style stocks. So quite interesting, huh? Then you come up with hybrid. So these are three things. But of course, I'm very sure you will have the fourth one and the fifth one. Okay, huh?